Hi, and welcome to Sweetaboy Gaming. Today, reading a story I made yesterday from when this is recorded. It's all about... But yeah, I'm gonna read stories. A story I wrote, and it's called Olaf the Wizard. It's a very weird story, and it's a terrible story, but I just randomly wrote it while listening to Zelda's lullaby. Not kidding. Once upon a time, there was this beautiful young boy named Olaf. It happened so that Olaf was a wizard from a Nordic tribe. He was not liked by the tribe because of his magic, and that was perfectly fine by Olaf. He wasn't the guy that talked a lot. He sat in his shelter by himself and tested new tricks. One day, there was a storm that swept the whole land and wiped out all the Nordic tribes. Olaf was the only survivor of the tribe, and he knew that it was his responsibility to rebuild the tribe to its former selves. So the next day, Olaf started his journey to their enemy tribes in the west. A few days passed, and also no one heard nothing, and he thought to himself, "This storm wasn't the normal storm." I finally came to the border, and he saw two guards standing at the gates. Knowing his appearance, they wouldn't let him pass. But as Olaf also was a bright one, he continued towards the gate and said, "Hi, my name is Olaf of the Nordic tribes, and I am here to seek shelter." The guards looked at him suspiciously and wondered, "Who is he?" Then one of the guards asked, "Why, young one, do you seek shelter in the west when your allies are in the east?" Olaf answered, "Because the eastern border is closed by the order of the tribes." The guards continued to look at him and then decided that they would call on the captain. The captain comes down, and she is a beautiful lass with short hair and an armor of the finest steel that can be found in this part. She walked towards Olaf and asked him, "Why, young one, do you seek shelter in west, knowing we are your enemies?" Olaf answered, "I seek shelter because I am the final of my tribe, and I am not here for war." The captain looked down at Olaf and thought, "He is a weird one." They told the guards to arrest him and take him to the cell. The cell was dark and had a real damp feeling. Next day, the captain comes down, goes towards Olaf and says, I am Captain Eldred of the Western Tribe." Olaf looked up at her and said, "Your name strikes fear in many people. Your legacy is known in the Nordic tribes as the fearless lass of the West." She was taken aback of his calm answer. Knowing her stories, Olaf sat there waiting. Astrid turned around and said, "Olaf of the Nordic tribes, you're a weird one, knowing so much yet fearless." Olaf just looks back and says, "Fear is many things, my lady." A few days later, Olaf gets released and Astrid says, "Under order of the Western tribes, you are to be released and taken back to your homeland." Olaf looks back at Astrid and then back towards the Nordic border, feeling the sand in his heart. He never cared about his people, but he loved them all as they was his family. He then says, "The storm that came was from the east and destroyed all the tribes, yet I still stands." Astrid looked at him shocked. Then she turned around and walked back, and Olaf was escorted back towards his home. Late that day, Astrid sat at her table in the tower and thought, "That storm could have destroyed everyone, yet he lived and knows the truth about who did it." The next day, she asked one of the guards to send out a scout to the north. A few days passed until the scout came back and told her, "Oh, my lady, the north is no more, destroyed to nothingness." Astrid told the scout to go away and now returned back to her thinking. A few days later, Olaf returns once again. Astrid sees this and tells the guard to open the gates for him. Olaf goes towards Astrid and says, "You know now what have happened here, and I once again ask, can I seek shelter in west?" And Astrid says, "Young one, we can't let you in without the permission of the tribes, and you're an enemy of our tribes." They then looked at each other. All of them said, "You could have killed me a few days ago, knowing I was the last one. Yet here I stand. Why is that?" Astrid looked back at him, knowing that she couldn't answer that question. She then said, "I don't know the minds of our tribes, but nonetheless, you're an enemy." Olaf stood there with a sad look. "I lost everything, and yet I have everything." She looked at Olaf and thought, What does he mean? He has everything. And before she could ask, he said, I can destroy this and everything around this water. She then, for the first time, looked back at someone with fear in her eyes. Olaf then walked past her and continued towards west. Later that day, Olaf seeked shelter for the night in a nearby town. The next day, Olaf walked out of the inn and he had slept in. He stood eye to eye with the commander of the western tribes. The commander, he was a handsome man with nice short hair, as most western tribes had. With green gleaming eyes and a sword as beautiful as him, Olaf looked at him and winded. The commander looks back, then he says, I am the commander of the western tribes. My name is known in the south as the undead and in the north as the dragon. Yet my name is Jan. Olaf looks back and says, I am Olaf. You are here to seek me out, knowing I crossed your border without permission. Jan looked back at him and thought, this one is smart. He looked at each other and the commander did the one thing no coming down before him. He said, you may pass this land. A few days later, the end of the western tribes came. All of them thought, who sent this storm? Who will do something this evil? He continued his journey towards the south, a few miles from the south where he saw two things he didn't like to see. As when Jan was walking down the path, when they saw Olaf, they drew their sword and said, you are under arrest for the destruction of the western tribes. Olaf looked confused and said, why am I guilty on no proof? As she answered this,
the power you spoke of, I have only seen it happen on two different occasions. The first in the north and the second in the west.
Olaf then realized something. He was the man who killed them without knowing it. He was the man that destroyed true tribes and seek to destroy all the tribes. Then looked back at Asher and asked, how come you to leave while the rest is dead? John looked at Olaf. I am not called the dragon of the north, without a reason, nor the undead of the south. Olaf then understood that he would die for the hand of the greatest warriors in the western tribe, and he said calmly, I am now doomed to die, yet I feel like I will live on. Al took out her blade and said, I,
Astrid of the western tribes, sent here Olaf of the Nordic tribes to death.
Olaf stood there, waited, as she swung her sword and it hit flesh, and she saw the body fall. She looked down and said,
you once told me you seek shelter, now your shelter have found you.
A few days later, Jon and Elsie left the west and tried to find their own paths. The end. I know it's a terrible story, but it's a short story I just made up while doing something. I don't know why, but reading it out loud now, I see a little bit that it wasn't too bad. It kind of connected a bit of that sometimes you don't know what the thing you do is. That's basically the message I got out of this myself, and I wrote it. I didn't have a minute to get a message. It was just meant for a little short story, and in the end it gets a message that sometimes you do stuff you don't remember out of anger, out of a lot of stuff, but in the end it isn't meant for stuff to happen. But nonetheless, don't forget to subscribe, like, give me a comment, tell me about it, and I will see you guys in the next episode of whatever I'm playing or doing or whatever this channel is becoming. I don't know. But adios, see ya.